boys and girls. It is me, Duke CT, here live on the Duke CT Lounge. Just watching right now the NFL game is going on with my Washington Redskins losing, as usual, to the New York Giants. Seems like it's a yearly tradition. Redskins looking at least somewhat competent the last week, and then, you know, the whole, you know, and everything just drops down. You know, everything just goes to completely awry. Cousins already threw an interception. The Redskins already have a safety, had a safety against them. And, you know, the Giants haven't capitalized on it and such. And now, Hall is basically done. D'Angelo Hall, one of our best corners, is now pretty much done for the game. Probably not for the end, probably the entire season. Goody. Yeah, this is just, this is the reason why, we can't have nice things, you know? Again, this is like, the Giants is going off for some. This is why, you know, us Giants fans, we can't have nice things. Just continuing a fail. And oh, by the way, to continue on it, just a little rant too, before I get into the pro wrestling and such. Is that, former coach, Mike Shanahan, said before the game, says, Kirk Cousins looks like a young John Elway. Yeah. A young John Elway that missed so many passes, looks completely spooked, and just, well, honestly, looks out of his depth. When is this team just going to drop him and RG3 and just roll with Colt, go 4-12, get another quarterback, and keep building the offensive line, and just move on? Get rid of Gruden as a coach, too. Anyway, well, let's talk a little something. A little more positive. To keep down with the down move, Vince McMahon is pissed off. Bill Vinnie Mac is pissed at the ratings. He's pissed off. You know, just really upset. You know, because the ratings have been terrible. You know, the ratings have gone down. He's talking to his crew and everything else, saying this stuff. Supposedly Brian Alvarez is said that he was upset, saying the rising shake things up. And now supposedly the big shakeup is going to be, boys and girls, is Sheamus becoming WWE champion. Look, I understand Rollins isn't setting the world on fire. He hasn't. His heel stick is terrible. And on the real, he should be like the Jeff Hardy. I'm serious. There's money to make with Seth Rollins being like the Jeff Hardy. And the Giants just converted a fourth down. Of course they do. Of course they do. Of course they do. Because the Giants will win. And they will, fail and such. speaking of failing, if the WWE turns to Sheamus, if the WWE turns to Sheamus, it's not going to change much. It's the same thing we had Sheamus going back in 2009. They're trying to make Sheamus happen. Sheamus is not going to happen. It's never going to happen. Sheamus is basically this, you know, he can give good matches, he can do all these type of things, he can be up there. I mean, but the WWE just sabotage him, they push him too quickly, pushed him too fast to WWE title, and when he got the WWE title, he was more of an afterthought. He's an afterthought champion. In fact, both times he was an afterthought champion. The show wasn't really focused on him. The only time he did was when he was a world champion, didn't get announced on SmackDown, and no one really cares about SmackDown. Anyway. Yeah. Vince losing the rings. I honestly think this is, you know, it's the chickens coming home to roost. The whole backstage element in this is because he just did not know how to manage talent well. Vince McMahon does not know how to craft stories. He doesn't know how to make talent well. And every time the talent gets over themselves, they get all higher and higher. It seems like the writers continue to write stupider things against them. That's why I just dread. I think they had a table for three in New Day. They actually said they dread actually when they get broken up because, you know, they're just like, oh my goodness, they're going to be stuck in this horrendous, they're going to be stuck in their little roles. Kingston, I honestly think with Kingston, this new thing with Kingston, I wish he would have won the Money in the Bank briefcase. He should have won the Money in the Bank briefcase and actually did something. Cash in on that. Sheamus is just too, he's not really, I don't care for Sheamus. Majority of people don't care about Sheamus. People that matter actually watch the show. Sheamus wins, and okay, you get minor pop, but no one cares. And basically, front loading your main event scene with all the old guys. Seriously, the Go Home Show. You have Steve Austin, Undertaker, Brock Lesnar, Shawn Michaels. You know, just say hello to the old guys. And I know the Undertaker and Brock Lesnar having their final epic conclusion in Hell in a Cell. And I don't care. The last match was good, but it was unnecessary. I don't want to see Brock Lesnar fighting old guys. I want them to fight newer, younger talent. What is wrong with that? Can someone tell me what is wrong with them actually getting young talent? What's wrong with that? Someone tell me what is wrong with this, with actually having Brock Lesnar fighting younger talent, more interesting stuff happen. Like, I wouldn't mind it. No one would mind it. So, yeah. Again, people, I know. It's a fool's gambit. I know people are going to be like, don't worry about the ratings. But again, this is a company that is just looking for so much of the short term and not looking for the long term. SmackDown is basically rendered useless. I mean, pointless, actually. Pointless by its years and years of irrelevancy because they ended the brand extension. And I was one of the people who wanted to keep the brand extension. If you look past my old videos, and you know, don't cringe too much. I wanted to keep the brand extension. I wanted them to continue and heck having more SmackDown and more Raw exclusive pay-per-views. In fact, I wanted them to have something I wish they can do right now. I think most wrestling fans and wrestling shooters have been saying this for a while. Have an off-season. An off-season would make this so. I mean, if you have an off-season, they can take a couple big, like a month or 2 months to relax. We can go here, there, and I'm like, you know what? It's a way to can recharge your batteries, not for the performers and wrestlers and the commentators, but also the writers and the bookers, you know, that sort of thing. Get them fresh ideas moving, chugging along. That's what the Lucha Underground is doing. I mean, they, by the way, congratulations for Lucha Underground getting a season 2. A lot of people are happy. I really, really wish that I had Lucha Underground instead of the fail that is Destination America, so I can get TNA all the time. Yay! I just can't do this anymore. I can't just watch TNA and everything else. It just pissed me off. So, maybe I'll get Chris Lee Moore. I mean, maybe I'll get some other guest here and actually talk about how the WWE can be better, you know, instead of hearing my rambling voice for over an hour and such. Maybe I can get some other people to, you know, like-minded, or maybe people who think the WWE is going on the right course. I need to find, if you are, email me, contact me, we'll do a little podcast together or something. I don't know. I wanted to see what's going on. Okay. Anyway, let's talk a little bit of a positive here. Let's talk about Ring of Honor. keeping the wrestling thing. Let's talk about Ring of Honor. Ring of Honor's All Star Extravaganza 7. A great show. A very awesome show. And I will get to that after this little musical break. Yes, I'm going to be doing some musical break here. I need to parse my little watai and everything else. So I will get back to you with this. And let's see what some music will be great for you. Let's play a little something that will make you happy. Let's see. Ooh, let's keep the Mario theme, boys and girls. Let's look at Super Mario World Bowser is Champion OC Remix by BXM Music. Take a listen. It's great. You'll love it. And anyway, thank you once again for listening to me live here on TalkShoe.com and everywhere else in between. This is the Duke CT Lounge. We'll be right back right after this. Live here on the Duke CT Lounge. Thank you so much for joining me here. Let's see. And now they're starting the Griffin thing. And yeah, he's watching. And Cousins is not doing good. You know what this happens, boys and girls. Well, that's the quarterback controversy. Just looking. And Cousins looking lost. And pick, of course. Pick, of course. Future of the franchise, boys and girls. Future of the Washington Redskins. A complete sad sack of fail. Doesn't know what to do. He's passing to cover it. Passing to everyone else is. That's how, yeah. You know what? Yeah, that's what he is. Grossman. Yeah, Cousins is basically. Yeah, you know what? Rex Grossman is Kirk. Yeah. Cousins is Rex Grossman without success. And we're stuck with him the entire year. All y'all people wanted to say, oh, they're going to the Super Bowl. Yeah, right. This game gives them a nice little wake-up call. Anyway. Let's scratch to something awesome. Something that's the opposite of Washington. An organization that actually does things. They actually are competent. Not being that total nonstop action of the NFL. Right down to the incompetent owner. Gosh. Why do things I care about are run by complete morons? It's just, why? Anyway. Something awesome. Ring of Honor All-Star Extravaganza. What a show. And then, honestly, not a bad match. I enjoyed the craziness of it. I loved All-Star Weekend. I actually loved it. Really good stuff. There are some things I didn't like, some things I did. But overall, I had a great time watching this game. Watching this this pay-per-view. I had a whole lot of fun. First up, we have the Ring of Honor World Television Championship. Jay Lethal taking on Bobby Fish. A really good match. The opener. I honestly thought that Jay Lethal was going to lose the TV title here. Because, I mean, he's held it for over a year. I didn't know who's going to do it. At this point, I honestly would not be surprised he might drop it at Final Battle. I hope so. And the person who does drop it, who drops it to him, I want it to be Moose. I want it to be Moose because the dude deserves it. And the reason why I'll talk to that later on the show. But anyway, Bobby Fish and these guys have good chemistry, really good chemistry with each other. The action was great. The pacing was really good. I enjoyed it. I love the fact that Bobby Fish was looking for submissions on the leg and got him a lot of times. And the lethal I hate the lethal injection. Lethal combination should be his finisher. The lethal combination, the backbreaker to a faceplant. That's awesome. Why is that not finished? The lethal injection is basically like the, you know, it's the pro wrestling equivalent to a, you know, comic book villain saying, oh, you know, basically monologuing. And monologuing saying, I'm going to beat you and such. And then have the monologuing is pointing to the hero of the story. But actually having the plan actually work. It's so convoluted. I honestly, that's the whole thing. Jay Lethal is the perfect package, but if you took away the lethal injection, I think it would be, you know, it'd be even better. He's great. He's all that, but the lethal injection holds him back. I really think if he needs to get a new finisher or something, a submission, something, because it just seems really just overly contrived. Just very overly contrived. But in the end, he wins. He beats Bobby Fish by the most dangerous move in pro wrestling day. And pro wrestling today, boys and girls, a schoolboy. But he had the tights too, so yeah. He retains the TV title. I really did enjoy this match. Next up is the for the boys, Dalton Castle versus Silas Young. I can't speak. I'll take on this match. It was the winner will have if Dalton Castle wins, Silas Young joins the boys. His personal ring. I don't know what the boys do, but they just honestly just make Dalton Castle more weirder, and I love him for it. Just their man service, I don't know. If Silas Young wins, he gets the boys. This was a fun match. I really liked it. It was slow at some points, but I really did enjoy the story here. Silas Young, however, takes the boys, uses the distraction, and wins with the misery. And Silas Young is now the soul of the boys. He's going to make them two real men. You're going to make them feel real good. You can just, the boy's like, no. And then he's like, yeah, I'm going to make real men of you. Yeah. How did they make a change of tire? How did he get oil from a car? Make them into real men. I bet that final battle, you will have Dalton Castle versus Stevenson to get the bat to win them back, the boys and such. But overall, a fun match. Next up is I don't have the whole match. Let's see. I want to make sure that I, because it was a fun pay-per-view. I don't want the whole match settings and such. I want to see what the card was after this. Yes, I was right here. Jay Lethal, this. But we have the next match was the Briscoe Brothers taking on a mystery opponent. And for that, we had Adam Page and BJ Whitner, the Decade, coming out, hyping up the match with Adam Page and Jay Briscoe. I don't really care for Adam Page. He's like, honestly, the reason why I don't like Adam Page is because of his just, you know, I don't know. Maybe that's just the standing idiot moonsault for a form. I mean, that's just flippy stuff for flippiness. I can't stand it. I just, eh. You know what I mean, people? But, moving on. They were on commentary. And Carino was like, you know, just like, basically just silent doing everything. BJ Whitner, he is a total heel. And I like that. and you see, and he's taking on and who are the mysterious people? Who are the mysterious teams? It was, you know, a lot of people saying it was going to be this team or that team. It was the all night at the return of, first it was the romantic touch came out and did some little silly things with Jay Briscoe, what have you. And after that, it was the return of the All Night Express, Red Titus and Kenny King. They made their return, former Ring of Honor Tag Team Champions. And they fought, and they had a, this was a pretty good match. And they were back, and the crowd was really surprised seeing them. And I dread the fact when they go back to us, you know, Chicago or Philadelphia crowd. Oh, I just can't wait to hear the racist chants directed to Kenny King. Look, I understand Kenny King left Ring of Honor in a very precarious position. Ring of Tag Team belts, and, you know, I honestly think it was a really bad call from Kenny King. But hopefully he learned a lesson. Everyone else learned a lesson. Hopefully they can move on. Hopefully the fans can move on. Because if it gets into that point, if it gets to that point, boys and girls, where they go to, I hope the fans moved on as well. If it was New York, and if, because honestly, in this era of the pro wrestlers, man, pro wrestling is not looking good for the most part. You know, they, you know, as a, we have a bit of a black eye and such, you know, as Lobo Entertainment and such. How's it going to look when he goes to New York and Chicago and there's a huge racist chant directed to Kenny King? Oh, that's going to be so much fun. And, of course, I can hear the freedom. Like, oh, they have a right to say it. They bought their ticket. Freedom of speech. Yes, freedom of speech. That means directive, like, that means governments can't silence you. But I want a little self-censorship yourself. Please, if you're going to be pissed at Kenny, keep it to yourself. Please, fine, boo him or whatever. But please, I beg for the Ring of Honor fans, if they are listening, any of the hardcore Ring of Honor fans that go to New York or Chicago, please, please don't, do not chant the racist stuff, please. Especially if it's going to be a live internet show or pay-per-view. It's going to be even worse then, because you know people are going to save that. They're going to put that on. Heck, they might sneak in a house show, they're going to put that on the internet. Believe you me, and trust me, ROH is doing pretty good right now, and they don't. And wrestling is not really looking good. Hogan doing his racist chants, racist stuff. We don't want the, yeah, if Hogan doing like his racist stuff back a couple months ago, but now, you know, I don't want to have, you know, Ring of Honor fans or, you know, or what have you, or wrestling fans in general lumped up with Hogan or something, saying that they're nothing but privileged white dudes who just are basically redneck white dudes who are racist. Well, maybe I'm wrong. But I'm hopeful I'm wrong. You know, that's the hope. Anyway, All Night Express and Briscoes had a very good match. And yeah, All Night Express wins. Adam Page sneak attacked Jay Briscoe. But in the end, All Night Express came back in and chased the Decade out. And what have you, and, you know, setting up their match for Ring of Honor television. Next up is the no disqualification match as Moose with Stokey Holloway taking on Cedric Alexander with Veda Scott. And let's see, this match, oh boy. This match to me showed me that Moose is going to be a big time player, and Cedric Alexander too. I think Cedric Alexander showed me that last year on last year at Best in the World 2014. That's my personal thing. But Moose, I think he is so on the cusp because this was really good. Even though there was a little, I think it was like a basically a ladder botch with. He, Moose was about to do a little plancha off the top rope, going to like the top rope to a ladder, and Cedric Alexander moved a little too quickly, and you know, Moose just kept running after you moved. There was nobody on the ladder. Like, I thought he was going to stop. Nope, he goes full force and just hits the ladder by himself. I don't know. That was a bit, you know, that was only my little nitpick of the match. But overall, and Odell with a touchdown and the Giants won the game. Yeah, I know it's the fourth quarter, but yeah, this game's over. And the Kirk Cousins getting kicked off the team stuff is all going to be the narrative next week. The Giants always seem to get better with Washington. Well, c'est la vie. Anyway, again, Moose has some real stuff. Like, I love that little helmet joy he did with Cedric and John. I love that. All this stuff was built up really good, and including the managers got into it as well. And, yeah, and in the end, Moose defeats Cedric Alexander with the wrench and a spear onto the table. And he hits the 1-2-3 and was victorious. And I will say this about Moose. He keeps his momentum. I want him to be the one to take out Lethal. I want him to be the takedown Lethal and for the TV title. And I honestly think that would be the best thing. And, you know, hey, Moose with the TV belt, have him just dominate for a while. I'm all in on that. Who else is? Come on. Let's see. What else? Let's move on. ACH takes on Matt Sydal. Good match. Single match of the best of five series. Hopefully, at the end of the series, the winner gets a title shot for the TV title. Hopefully, that is, instead of just a best of five, whatever. ACH has some really good stuff here. And so did Matt Sydal. This is really good stuff here. I like the match. I'm always a fan of ACH. I think he really is. I like his high-flying stuff. I really do. Really good high-flying stuff here. Both guys have good chemistry with each other. Pacing was really good. It did last a little bit long. I think it should have ended like a 13 minutes instead of 16 minutes. I think it just went away for a while. But overall, I really did enjoy this match. I really enjoyed it as ACH picks up the victory. And Matt Sydal looking like, okay, he's down 2-1. But I heard they had the fourth match and Matt Sydal wins, so it's now tied up. And it's going to go down to a fifth match. Next up is the tag team three-way match for the Ring of Honor World Tag Team Championship. As The Kingdom, Matt Taven and Michael Bennett with Maria Kanellis takes on The Addiction, Crystal Daniels and Frank Azarian, and The Young Bucks, Matt Jackson and Nick Jackson. And wow, what a match. It was fun, exciting. Heck, The Kingdom didn't really get much chance until they talked like on Sensen's like We Like Maria or something. But overall, it was fun, exciting. These three teams have really good chemistry with each other. It was fun. But there was some shenanigans to the match, shenanigans as the KRD won. Someone with a KRD mask, the red mask, the Knights of the Red Dawn, came in and super kicked. I think it was Frankie Kazarian. Let's see. I think that's what happened. And Christopher Daniels gets knocked around by the Kingdom and it got a pinfall, and the Kingdom became new tag team champions. But that wasn't done for the Kingdom. Oh, there was more trickery and such afoot. But I really did enjoy this matchup. You know, trust the Kingdom, but yeah, that's just me. I would like to see the Young Bucks get it. Because, hey, you know, I like the Young Bucks. Next up is AJ Styles taking on Roderick Strong, Adam Cole, and Michael Elgin in a four-corner survival match for the number one contendership to the Ring of Honor World, the Heavyweight Championship. Great match. I mean, Malcolm Elgin, I think he needs a change of attire because that whole little singlet thing is not working for him. I would love to see just like, you know, not singlet, just like regular trunks or something like that. Just trunks, just what have you, because I think that would really help him. Because, you know, the crowd was really on Malcolm Elgin. They really did some good stuff. AJ Styles did some good stuff, even though he did a bit of a botch. Yeah, he didn't hit that springboard DDT that off well, but they recovered pretty well. Roderick Strong looked pretty good too. Adam Cole looked really good, and there's a bit of a problem with that. I thought Adam Cole was going to win, but then AJ Styles picks up the victory, so it's going to be, he is a new number one contender for the Ring of Honor world title. And and AJ Styles shook the hands and everybody else, and everybody shook hands and, you know, did the whole code of honor stuff and everything else. Next up is now our main event as Jay Lethal, the World Heavyweight Champion, takes on Kyle O'Reilly of Red Dragon. And yeah, Lethal still wounded from the last battle all the way at the beginning of the show. And I have to say, this match was very good, even though you can really see Lethal really starting the injuries and what Bobby Fish did to the leg and then the arm. And it looked like it was a really fun matchup. Looked like Lethal was going to lose the title at some points. And it looked really close. It looked like it was really close. Then you had, it got a very odd type of TNA finish. I'm serious. It was really a TNA finish. Truth Martini came out with him, and then Truth Martini doing some shady things, and Ring of Honor head guy, Nigel McGuinness, said, "Nope, no, you ain't gonna do that. You're not gonna do that." And dragged him out, and just like said, "It's over, man." You know, it's you're out tonight. And then one of the held up members of the House of Truth, Devon Dijak, I really think he's going to be really good. Seriously, he's like 6'7". Honestly, this guy, I think he's a little wet behind the ears. I think he's going to be really good. Devon Dijak, and he trying to help him out, trying to take down Kyle O'Reilly. But then you had Bobby Fish come out and all this type of stuff, saying he wants to chase the jet and all this type of stuff. But then, Bobby Fish came out later. And so then you have Deion Dijak, who was having you taking them out. And then you had Adam Cole come out. Adam Cole came out and was about to help his partner as Bobby Fish was taking on Demon Dijak, or what have you. And next thing you know, Adam Cole betrays him with a super kick. And Lethal, wobbly as heck, hits the Lethal Injection, which I'm like, really? Dude, you were unconscious most of the match. You were like, barely didn't know what was going on. Stood there, hands bringing an ace cutter. I'm like, dude, just no. But in the end, Jay Lethal retains his world title and his world title. He is still the double champion, TV and world title champion holder at the end of this evening. And after that, Adam Cole and the rest of the kingdom came out. Looks like it was all one big thing just to screw with Kyle O'Reilly's head. And they all, long loop the kingdom and just did this triple super kick. And they laid out both Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish. And honestly, this was a good pay-per-view, but the ending was a little bit wonky for me. I just didn't really care for it. I felt that I think there'd been more meat to it if Adam Cole would have won the number one contendership match, rather than AJ Styles, because I think Styles Lethal is going to be great. I can't wait to see that, but I'm like, know what I mean? You know, I think it was a really missed opportunity. And I think they're trying to do something, or Kingdom win the world title and, you know, what have you. But I don't know. Maybe they could do something with, something like that. Maybe they'll find a third guy. I don't know. But to offset the Kingdom. But I don't understand that. I don't really understand the whole meaning to have Kyle O'Reilly take on. Kyle O'Reilly taking on. Adam Cole. Adam Cole, that match could have been great, but overall, I think that thing could have been easy to set up. Set up easier. Heck, I just don't really know. anymore about this. I don't know what they're doing, but Ring of Honor does have a lot of trust in me, to, you know, because they built up a lot of trust. They had great matches and everything else. So I just want to see, where they're going to lead to. So I want to see where it goes. Yes, they banked out a lot of trust. ROH had banked out a lot of trust with me, so I want to see where this goes. And, anyway, that was a little bit fun, boys and girls. Next up, I will talk a little about Star Fox getting delayed, Star Fox Zero getting delayed, and Vixen, the next Vixen review. Hopefully, this show is not going to last too long. Anyway, we'll be right back right after this. Let's see what song can I play to get this thing on. Let's see, a little more Mario. How about that? I'm going to do a whole Mario thing. How about Super Mario Land? I didn't play this one. Super Mario Land, Real Big Mario. Computer artists, Jax and Kaijin. Hope you like that here live on the Dukect Lounge. Thank you so much for joining me here live on TalkShoe.com. Be right back right after this. Back here live here on the Duke CT Lounge. Thank you so much for joining me here on TalkShoe.com. Anyway, remember, folks, boys and girls, you can always catch this show on iTunes, YouTube at youtube.com/DukeCT, on manicexpression.com, ScrewAttack.com. You have to update that thing to ScrewAttack.com on the user place, whatever. Zipcast, Sessions. CCS Cat Studio Forums, CCS Podcast Forums. I'm going to put that up there. The Escapist Forums, and on the Deck Out of the Glasses Forums as well. Hopefully you enjoy it. Hope you like, all the good stuff. Hopefully I'm entertaining it. And also I'm on iTunes, so yeah. I can't believe I keep forgetting this stuff. The Freaking Awesome Network. Yes, you can find me on The Fan, Freaking Awesome Network. You guys, again, I am so humbled to be on that website. Thank you. Anyway, another year, another delay, another day, another game delay. This time it's for Nintendo, Star Fox Zero. It is delayed, boys and girls, and it's going to be delayed for basically Q1 of 2006. And supposedly, in an interview, Shigeru Miyamoto is saying the game is pretty much finished, but there's still some problems, I think, with the with some of the stuff is in the game. They want to make sure it's very good, all this stuff. They want to make all the bugs and everything else ironed out, which is a shame because I love seeing Star Fox bring that back. But instead, looks like we're going to have to wait a little while, and it sucks. I don't know what Nintendo means. Super Mario Maker is great, and I'm going to get it. That's what I'm going to be getting, and I will be streaming that soon. And by the way, I will be streaming on, streaming Friday. I've been doing this. It's going to be a thing. I'm going to be doing a thing every Friday. I'm going to be streaming. If everything permits, I'm going to be streaming. I'm doing Blood Dragon. Fall Country Blood Dragon, doing all the stuff, going to missions and everything. Hopefully y'all are enjoying it. I get a lot of positive feedback, and I'm going to keep doing it. I love it. Love it. Anyway, it sucks that Star Fox Zero, back to the point, Star Fox Zero getting delayed. And but yet, there's other games like Chronicle X. I'm going to be definitely getting that. I might pre-order that soon. I can't wait to play that game. I already played Xenoblade Chronicles. I love that for the Wii. I love it. I'm not playing that and stuff, which Right now, I'm actually playing The Last Story, and right now, I'm actually trying to get back into, let's see, what game? I think it was, the game. Oh, yes, GameCube game, Skies of Arcadia. I'm playing that again. I'm loving it. I'm really enjoying that. So, overall, I'm feeling really good, and I'm hopefully Star Fox will come back and be better than ever. And speaking of better and such, Vixen, yes, Vixen. Episode 5. One episode for the series finale. The season finale. I'm going to continue doing this. I really like this show. Again, and let's set the show for these 5-minute episodes. Let's set the stage for you. Setting the stage for this show. For the 5-minute show of animated stuff of Vixen. Yes, I'm sorry my singing disturbs you, but it's my voice and singing, so yeah. Anyway, I enjoyed it. I mean, again, I really enjoyed it. You have a nice little twist, the story, and you have this woman, and you know, this woman, Vixen, or what have you. Not Vixen's other woman. You have the that red, the woman in red. Lady in Red. Yes, the Lady in Red. But there are two big goons trying to take down the little amulet that Mari has. But it seems that it's bonded to her. Anyway, and she knocks her out. And he takes him all the way to Africa. And he finds out the girl, the Lady in Red. Oh, I have spoilers. Spoilers! Spoilers. She's actually her sister. Yeah, they're related. Yeah, that's really odd. But, it's not the first time I had a show. See shows pro tags and antagonists going against each other or actually sisters. Hello, Kill la Kill. Anyway, when is that dub coming on Netflix? But anyway, yeah. Oh, by the way, Washington is at the red zone, and I cannot wait to see Kirk Cousins draw another pick. Yeah, let's see. One possession, one field goal in the red zone. So much fail. I'm expecting it. Let's see what happens. And let's see what Kurt's going to do. And except, oh, they moved. And neutral zone extraction. And yada, yada, yada. Well, we're going to move on for that. But anyway, Vixen was it was false start, of course. Always a delay of game. Yes. Well, time management. Yeah, Jay Gruden, that little thing about time management. Who cares about that? But anyway, Vixen, something good. They took her to Africa, talked about her village being, massacred by warlords. And her sister, wants to basically tend the place. She's like, she was the chosen one for the amulet. And yet, she's like, oh, I was missed, she was missed or what have you, and saying everything else. It's like, I was meant to have this and, to honor the dead and such. Like, there's nothing left in the village. But basically, this village is a mass grave. Yeah. She's tending over a mass grave. that's dark. Let's see. Matt Jones with a actually. Yep, it looks like it's a touchdown. Well, looks like it's not a touchdown or a fumble or whatever. Well, it looks like it's gonna be reviewed. Let's see. Jumps up and the ball is. Oh, the ball is loose. The ball is loose, so yeah, I think that's a fumble, and I don't know whose ball. I think that's maybe Giants. I don't know. Just I think, I don't know what happened. But anyway, of course, you know, and it ends in disaster in Washington. Let's see. Well, the episode ends as her sister, I can't remember her name, because of the spider. You know, since Anansi is her original form of spider, she has the spider bite Mari, you know, Vixen, what have you, and boom, you know, the power, you know, she still has a bit of a power of Rhino, knocks the two guards out, and then she runs away, says, she doesn't, that's not going to get that far. And then she collapses, and then next thing you know, she's in, she's in the middle of an African field, and she's like, yes, she can take off the bracelet, and say, now I have it. I'm like, that's your sister. I don't want to understand what was all this stuff going on. Now, hopefully the next episode fills that whole thing. Hopefully the next episode answers why she's just so, I don't know, just really determined to attack her sister like this. She's, I'm serious. I don't understand that. But that's just me. Anyway, overall, I really enjoyed. I enjoyed the episode. A little confusing, but overall, I still enjoy it. Vixen is still thumbs up me, and I can't wait for the season finale. Hopefully, they'll actually give her a true live action show to showcase her skills and let the voice actors actually act and have the whole thing there. Because I would really love that. That would be pretty awesome. I mean, hey, I wouldn't. I'd be down with that. They keep saying the same thing. So anyway, overall, I really didn't like this. I didn't like Vixen and what have you. Oh yeah, thanks to like thing here and whatever. It's like the runner cannot fumble the ball, and if anyone tries to recover it, that means it's an instant turnover. So that means the Giants get the ball at 20. Some reason. Yeah, of course. Of course that would happen with this team. And now this game is just about tick 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 away. It's basically. Yep, it is basically ball game. It's ball game, boys and girls. Yeah. Yeah, hold that ball, Mr. Jones. You have to hold that ball. You have to hold the ball a lot more tighter. Yeah. And a lesson he will learn. He will learn. And also he will learn how to lose a lot with. Oh, is that a fumble? I don't know. Was he down? I think he was down. He was down. He was down. I think he was down, so that's not count. So bring back to New York. I don't care. But anyway, overall, Vixen's fun. Redskins suck. And that's pretty much the show. Anyway, that's it for the show, boys and girls. Thank you so much for watching and listening on YouTube and iTunes and all that good stuff in between. Anyway, like I said, it was. They were all down, so it was pointless. Pointless time wasting. Anyway, thank you so much for listening, watching. This is Duke CT. Peace and love. I will see y'all when I see y'all later.